الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. My beloved brothers and sisters, very importantly, we must develop the correct relationship with Allah. No matter how many times we keep repeating this, it will not be enough as a reminder. No matter what we've done, we can always improve in our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my brothers and sisters, let's take it very seriously. Life on earth is very, very short. The average lifespan being between 60 and 70 years is extremely short compared to not only the everlasting afterlife, but even the existence of this particular earth has been for millions of years. My brothers and sisters, something has changed. I repeat, my brothers and sisters, something has changed. So what has changed? Well, if we were in the favor of Allah, in the blessings of Allah, living our lives in a beautiful way, and suddenly we're overtaken by anxiety or by a concern, a worry, a disease, a virus, something that has taken the globe by storm, something that has actually changed the way we do things. We don't know at times where the next morsel of food is going to come from, whether we're going to be having a job or not, whether we're going to get salaries or not, whether we're going to be able to pay our bills or not, whether we're going to make it through this time or not. Something has changed. My brothers and sisters, let's open the verses of the Quran and take a look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. For indeed, people are talking of how it is a punishment, and others are talking of how it is a blessing. But we should understand it is definitely Allah communicating with us in a unique way. Number one, He is showing us His power. He is showing us His might. And He is definitely showing us how helpless we are, no matter how advanced we have become as humankind. He can test us with something that we cannot even see, and yet we are so frightened of it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not make us from among those who are frightened, but rather from among those who prepare correctly and who smile at the decree of the Almighty at all times. My brothers and sisters, something has changed. Perhaps it is the way we have been doing things. If you take a look at the verses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us, ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ لَمْ يَكُ مُغَيِّرًا نِعْمَةً أَنْعَمَهَا عَلَىٰ قَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُوا مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ. Indeed, Allah is all-hearing and all-knowing. He hears everything. He knows absolutely everything. He says, Allah will never change the blessing that He has favored a nation with unless they have changed themselves. So therefore, something has changed. If a blessing has been snatched away, go back to Allah, turn to Allah, check your ways. Perhaps immorality has taken over. Perhaps prohibitions have taken over. Perhaps we're no longer taking the prohibitions seriously. Perhaps we're no longer taking the issue of character and conduct seriously. Perhaps we're not worshipping the Almighty the way He wants to be worshipped. Perhaps we're not following the messengers that He has sent to us with all the goodness, and we have discarded all the goodness. So Allah says, if I have blessed you with something, I'm not going to take it away unless you've changed and deserve for it to be taken away. So my brothers and sisters, something has changed. What exactly it is would differ from person to person, from a nation to nation. But in general, in order to get out of this mess that we're in right now, I promise you, we have to turn back to the Almighty in every single aspect of our lives. Let's start off by worshipping Allah alone. Let's start off by taking the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, his teachings, his ways, much more seriously. Life is not all about doing what we please, especially when it is in the transgression of the Almighty. Here he is showing us, man, you are totally helpless. Indeed, the kingdom, dominion belongs to Allah alone, completely. It is Allah who is in charge. He can change our lives with something we cannot see. And lives have changed. We will never be the same as we were in our lifetime. We have become more conscious of things we cannot even see. We need to be even more conscious of the Almighty, who was always there, whom we know, he who gave us life in the first place. Definitely, we will return to him and he will grant us that eternal life of the hereafter, wherein there will be bliss and goodness forever and ever. So, if things have changed, what do we do in order to change them back? Well, there is a similar verse again in the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَئِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَئِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ.
Indeed, Allah announces to you that if you are grateful, He will grant you increase in goodness. And if you are ungrateful, then His punishment is severe. From this verse, we learn definitely that gratitude to the Almighty, starting with worshipping Him the way He wants to be worshipped and following the messengers whom He has sent to us to remove us from the darkness to the light. We start with that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, gratitude will result in increase of the goodness you're in. So if you want increase in goodness, even if it is a little, you need to show gratitude to Allah. Become a better person. Be more conscious. Don't waste your time in immoral behavior. Don't waste your time in sin. Don't waste your time in that which will displease Allah. Do good deeds. Reach out to people. Care for one another. Make sure that you have developed a good relationship with people. Make life easy for others, not difficult for others. Those whom you live with, smile at them. Make their lives feel worthwhile by you contributing towards their lives in a positive way, and understand the Almighty will make your life worthwhile completely. And if you were ungrateful, showing ingratitude, then you have none other to blame than yourself. And this is why the Almighty says,
إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ وَإِذَا أَرَادَ اللَّهُ بِقَوْمٍ سُوءًا فَلَا مَرَدَّ لَهُ وَمَا لَهُم مِّن دُونِهِ مِن وَالٍ.
Amazing verses where Allah says, Allah will not change the condition of a person or a people, a nation, for as long as that person or those people do not change themselves. And this is talking about in a good way. So if you're in a bad situation and you want goodness to come in your direction, well then change. So this is different from the change we spoke about at the beginning of this lecture, where we said something has changed for the good we were in to have been taken away and replaced with anxiety and so on. And now this verse is telling us, if you want to change the negatives that you're in, you must make sure that you change yourself and become a much better person. That is the only time that everything will change. Today, more than ever, we are beginning to appreciate one another. We're beginning to appreciate people from all walks of life, all over the world, who are sacrificing their lives in order to save the lives of others. We pray for them, we appreciate them, and we definitely would like the Almighty to grant us some form of reprieve. We want some change, positive change. We want to be cured of this virus and the sickness. We want others to be cured of the virus and the sickness. Yes, the loss is for everyone. Everyone across the globe has tasted at least a little of what this virus has come with, yet we cannot see it. My brothers, my sisters, It's very important for us to soften the hearts towards Allah, to soften the hearts towards one another. Many of us have a very hard heart. It's time to change that. Develop your attitude and make sure that you are filled with gratitude. My brothers and sisters, change the hard heart, soften it. Start speaking respectfully to others. No matter how powerful you think you are, the Almighty has absolute control. We are nothing in front of Allah. It's only if we were to please Allah that He would grant us goodness. Remember, the calmness of the heart and the contentment, those are the gifts that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with. I want to spend a moment to pray for those nations where people are dying on a daily basis in large numbers. May Allah make it easy for them. May that stop. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant cure to all those who are sick and ill. Have mercy upon those who've passed away. The ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is humanity that is struggling. My brothers and sisters, at the same time, those countries not yet affected by this particular virus in a big way, don't be complacent. Two things can happen. Either we will be tasting what those nations are tasting right now in the very near future, and that is very possible. Complacency should not overtake us. But at the same time, if the Almighty wills, we could be saved the brunt of it if we were to learn lessons from the nations that have been affected in a big way. We would definitely be able to help our people as well by the mercy of Allah. Take it seriously. When people speak of lockdown, take it seriously. When people speak of social distancing, take it seriously. When people speak of staying at home, take it seriously. All these are from the teachings of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He has told us that when you hear of a plague, don't go into the place and don't come out of the place. In one narration, stay indoors, and if death were to overtake you indoors, you would definitely have the rank of a martyr. And in another narration, the Prophet, peace be upon him, speaks of so much of the goodness that the Almighty has brought to us. Indeed, there is no ailment except that the Almighty has sent its cure. It's just that people don't know the cure. My brothers and sisters, yes, we talk of prophetic medicines. We talk of home remedies. Those are probably very, very important at times like these. We need to take them seriously because we have a shortage of medical staff. We have a shortage of hospital beds. We have a shortage of medication. We have a shortage of so much. So don't lose hope. Those hot steam inhalations, those salt water gargles, the development of your immune system, whatever it may be, remember, nothing would harm you if you were to do the home remedies and lay your trust in Allah, which means it cannot do you any bad by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my brothers and sisters, it's important for us to look into the remedies of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, the natural remedies, simply to boost our immune systems. Nobody is saying that we have found the cure, but we are saying that it's important to deal with the remedies, to deal with the symptoms, with these home remedies that we have to begin with. We would be foolish if we sat back and relaxed and waited for help to come when help may never come. So therefore, my brothers and sisters, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, speaks of the black seed, powderized as well as its oil, beneficial to boost the immune system. Take it seriously if you have access to it. It would help you with the symptoms of a disease of this nature. My brothers and sisters, together with that, remember, there is no need to suffer with anxiety. Anxiety would probably diminish the strength of your immune system, thereby making you even more prone to being affected so negatively by such a virus. Be happy, be content, spend your days with your loved ones. Reach out to them on a daily basis if they're not with you. And at the same time, there is a lot of hope. There is hope at the end of the tunnel. It's just that at this juncture, we're going through great hardship and difficulty. Insha'Allah, I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He grant us cure and He help us to change our lives for the better. Brothers and sisters, like I said at the beginning, something has changed. What is it? Well, ask yourself, what is it? Have I obeyed Allah? Am I wasting my time? Do I flick through the pages of pornography and do I flick through pages wherein there is a lot of immorality that is being spread? Am I spreading immorality? Am I changing myself in a negative way? Am I doing things that would displease the Almighty? If that is the case, I could do better, inshallah. I could do much better to help myself and to help others. We could become people more conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and sisters, at this juncture, we should be reading, reciting from Revelation. We should be engaged in the remembrance of Allah, at least on a daily basis. We should be having a routine whereby we do things that would please Allah. Those who've never prayed have started praying. Isn't that a good sign? Those who've never thought of dressing modestly have started dressing modestly. Is that not a good thing? Those who've never thought of turning to Allah are ultimately calling out to Allah. Is that not a good thing? With all these good changes, indeed, we are invoking the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my brothers and sisters, very importantly, while we develop our relationship with Allah by worshipping Him alone, let's become people who follow the ways of the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah's peace and blessings and mercy be upon all of them and upon every one of us too. O Allah, we ask You to grant us cure. O Allah, we ask You to grant us cure. O Allah, we ask You to have mercy on those who've passed away. O Allah, strengthen those on the front line. O Allah, grant them strength and have mercy on them. O Allah, we ask You to bless every one of us, to take us out of the suffering. O Allah, we know we have changed. O Allah, help us to change in a positive way. Be pleased with us and alleviate the suffering that we're going through. O Allah, we ask You to grant us every goodness that the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, asked You to grant him. And we seek protection from all the evil that he has sought protection from. O Allah, have mercy on those who've passed on and make it easy for their loved ones. O Allah, have mercy on us the day we are going to pass away and make it easy for every one of us and our loved ones, Ya Allah. O Allah, those who are sick and ill, grant them cure. O Allah, those who are unwell, grant them cure. O Allah, the elderly, have mercy on them. Those who have compromised immune systems, O Allah, grant them strength and develop for them their immune systems. O Allah, help us in every single way. Help us appreciate the favors upon You, O Allah. We ask You every goodness, Ya Allah, and we seek protection from every evil. My brothers and sisters, it's important to continue calling out to Allah. Powerful prayers. Don't lose hope in the mercy of Allah. Reach out to others with hopefulness. Reach out to others with a lot of goodness. Share with one another beautiful remedies that are accessible to the people without claiming that you have a cure for the virus, but at least telling them the truth that it would actually help with the symptoms. And that's what we need. My brothers and sisters, it is not all doom and gloom. There is indeed the mercy of Allah. You and I know that the daybreak actually comes after the darkest hour of the night. At the moment, we are in this darkest hour of the night. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a daybreak, and may He make it for us as beautiful as it was and even more beautiful. And may He make us more conscious of Him. I pray that we can change our lives. And I pray that we promise that even if this entire situation were to improve in a tremendous way, we would not forget the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the Quran, in many places, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns us of the promises we make to Him. And then we go back on those promises once He takes our suffering away. So therefore, this time, let's change our lives permanently. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a positive change. Something has changed, and we need to change it back to the goodness and even better than what it was. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on every one of us, and may we be from among those who've taken heed. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.